knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
With some general characteristics covered, we are now beginning our journey through phylum Chordata, which will take us through an incredible variety of organisms. To start things off, within the phylum Chordata, there are three extant subphyla: Cephalochordata, which contains the lancelets; Tunicata, which contains the tunicates; and Vertebrata, which contains the vertebrates. Remember that all members of phylum Chordata share the five chordate characteristics we mentioned at least some point in their lives, those being the notochord, dorsal tubular nerve cord, pharyngeal pouches or gill slits, endostyle, and postanal tail. So let's begin our exploration of the chordates with subphylum Cephalochordata, the sister clade to the olfactories. There are fewer than 35 species of extant cephalochordates, all of which are found in the class Leptocardii and the order Amphioxiformes. They are commonly known as lancelets, or amphioxi, the singular being amphioxus. Extant forms are small, only 3 to 7 centimeters in length, slender, laterally compressed, translucent, and found in sandy sediments of coastal waters around the world. Modern lancelets closely resemble 530-million-year-old Picaia, likely one of the first chordates, fossils of which are known from the Burgess Shale. As such, they are often studied because they hold clues within their genomes about the evolution of early vertebrates. Let's go over their anatomy and physiology, ecology, and phylogeny. The anatomy of a lancelet is well known and often used as a model when learning about the five chordate characteristics. These characteristics are evident in an adult lancelet, and its body plan is considered to be ancestral for all chordates. Lancelets swim using their segmented muscles called myomeres, which attach directly to the notochord. Their movement is helped along by long flaps known as metapleural folds, but they lack the paired fins that are characteristic of the jawed vertebrates. In order to feed, lancelets keep themselves partially buried in fine sediments, with only their anterior end exposed. Water enters the mouth, driven by cilia in the buccal cavity and pharynx, and passes through the pharyngeal gill slits, where food is trapped in mucus secreted by the endostyle, and then moved into the gut, where food particles are separated from mucus and passed into the hepatic cecum, where they are digested. Lancelets have a closed circulatory system, but lack a heart and pigmentation. They also lack a respiratory system, and instead exchange gases directly through their skin. Thus, the pharyngeal gill slits function in food capture rather than respiration. The lancelet nervous system is centered around their dorsal hollow nerve cord that lies above the notochord. This notochord also extends into the head, where it is only slightly larger than in the rest of the body. Though the sensory system of the lancelets is often touted as simple, they do have numerous photosensitive organs, which include a single anterior ocellus, or frontal eye, and other cells and organs that line the body. Curiously, lancelets also express green fluorescent proteins in their oral tentacles and near the frontal eye that may play a role in attracting planktonic organisms. Lancelets are dioecious, and fertilization takes place externally in the water column. Fertilized eggs become ciliated neurula larvae that elongate and metamorphosize into adults. As adults, lancelets are benthic filter feeders that can swim when threatened or to find a better feeding location. They can be quite numerous locally, and when disturbed can quickly leave their burrow, swim a short distance, then rapidly burrow again, posterior end first, into the substrate. Though as adults they primarily feed on plankton, as larvae, they themselves are part of the planktonic community and may drift for great distances before settling into the substrate. One of the most commonly studied lancelets is B. lanceolatum, or the European lancelet, whose entire genome has been sequenced. Again, all species of extant lancelets are placed within the same class, Leptocardii, and order, Amphioxiformes. Lancelets are considered to be a model organism for vertebrate evolution. They were traditionally classified as the sister group to the vertebrates due to similar morphological features, but extensive molecular phylogenetic analyses have revealed that the cephalochordates are actually the most basal of the chordates, and the tunicates are the sister group to the vertebrates, meaning the tunicates have secondarily lost some chordate characteristics. And that's a bit of information on the cephalochordates. In the next tutorial, we will examine their sister group, the olfactories, and the split between clades Tunicata and Vertebrata.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.